Hi, welcome to the Movie Recapper. Today we will watch a horror, thriller, mystery movie from 2019, titled Awoken. This is a spoiler content video. The movie is about a young medical student that attempts to cure her brother from a terminal sleep illness called Fatal Familial Insomnia, where you are unable to sleep until you die. On her quest to help him, a more sinister reason for his condition is revealed. Enjoy the video and let's begin. One in three people have some form of sleep disorder. 95% of people who experience sleeplessness longer than 18 days rarely survive. The ones who live past this point do not need doctors, they need priests. The movie begins with a teenage boy weeping in his bed, as a grown man behind him gets up and zips up his pants. He orders him, and another younger boy to go to bed. But the younger boy is sitting on his bed, staring into nothing, and tearing off pages of a Bible. The man approaches him only to see the boy's eyes turn white, and hears him uttering Latin verses. The next instant, the grown man seems to be killed. Some years later, a girl named Carla is at the university, with her friend Alice. They are listening to a lecture given by Dr. Robert, who is also a father figure to Carla since her parents died. He's discussing the importance of sleep, while Alice is advising Carla to get some sleep herself. Carla hasn't been able to sleep, because her brother Blake is being treated for sleeplessness. The doctors have given up on him, and tell her to take him home. Carla's suggestion to treat him with drugs not legal in the country, but the doctors oppose her, telling her that you are still a student, and you should trust our experience. Carla walks to her brother's bed to ask how he is, and her brother says they are pulling me out one day. Another medical student named Patrick, pops up to meet Blake. Carla gives him a frosty hello, and it is established immediately that she has some history with Patrick. Carla seeks help from Robert, who tells her about the secret basement in the premises where he and Carla's father conducted experiments and studies not approved by the university. In fact, Carla's mother too was brought to the basement when she too faced a sleep disorder that she passed on to Blake. Carla doesn't need any more convincing because she wants to help her brother and her father, a well-known doctor in this field, according to his own book, was a friend of Robert's. Instantly, Carla tells Alice that she plans to go to the secret basement. Then Alice jumps on the wagon to help Blake. At the midnight, Carla and Alice go to the hospital to take Blake to the basement. And Patrick comes in too because Blake wants him nearby to play cards and stuff. Dr. Robert doesn't ask the two uninvited if they promise to keep all this confidential. And they all go to an elevator that needs a key. It's a creepy dimly lit basement with long corridors and supposedly restrooms that have been kept clean and decorated like a hotel room. There are two patients already being treated, Angela and Christopher. There is only one more bed and luckily Blake is here to occupy it. They start work, which is mostly just sitting in front of a window, to watch the patients and write tons of notes. Carla and Alice find a box behind a bookshelf. They find a book and videotapes of the experiment her father conducted inside the box. The two watch it and see that her father invited a priest. Robert is upset that Carla's father has invited the priest, but Carla's father knows something is off in his wife. He knows her beater and must have read about how people who don't sleep for more than 18 days require a priest. He's already ready with a priest. And when they wanted to watch the next videotape, they hear a sound and quickly hide the videotapes behind the bookshelf, and Patrick enters the room. Carla goes to the patient room to check on the patients. Blake starts to feel a little better, or so the others think, especially since his medication is changed. He is able to sit properly but keeps staring into space. Blake begins to tear off Bible pages. Apparently, it is mandatory to keep religious books near every patient. Patrick, unsuccessfully, tries to make amends with Carla, who sobs about how he left her the minute Blake was sick. Patrick replies that he is sorry, but that's not gonna work. Carla wants to get some sleep but she can't sleep. Then, Carla goes to check her brother and she finds out that Angela is very scared of Blake. Carla and Alice again start to watch continuation of videotapes and they see something strange. They see Carla's mother, and when they check it again, they couldn't see her. In the rest of the video, They see two patients in the room with Carla's mother who are very scared, but she sits comfortably and stares into a corner. Then they see him tearing up the pages of the Bible. Then Carla stops the videotape and goes to check the patients. Other patient, Angela tells Carla that Blake trying to get me and he keeps whispering scary words and talks with someone and nobody's there. She says I can't stay here, but Carla scares and tells her everything will be okay and leaves the room. Alice is in the bed and she is reading the book that they were found. Christopher is occupied with his headphones, which leaves Angela to hear Blake whisper all the time. This terrifies her and she keeps looking at Blake. Soon Angela goes berserk because she can't take Blake slurping his cereal. She yells to be let out, but only Carla is present because she doesn't like to sleep. She doesn't try to talk to Angela or rush in immediately. Instead, she lets Angela walk up to a chair and hang herself using the microphone. Carla comes in. The demon inside the Angela says a present for you, KJ. The demon knows Carla well enough to call her KJ. Now she is dead. Carla believes that Blake made her to kill herself, but Dr. Robert thinks another way and tells her she was really sick. The students are now tasked with disposing of the body when no one is supposed to know what is going on. The elevator key doesn't turn. A call is made for help, but maintenance will take their time to arrive sometime tomorrow. Carla again goes to check her brother, then Blake trying to choke her and says I'm gonna kill you, just like I did your mother. Carla runs away and exits the room. Patrick comes to Carla's room to speak with her and tells her what she thinks about Angela's death is just an illusion. You are tired and it's better for you to get some sleep, but Carla believes there is something going on here. Now, Carla is okay with letting Patrick watch the tapes with her. They see that the experiment on Carla's mother didn't go well either. She tore off Bible pages and stuck them to the window with blood from the other patients. All the people involved in the study are ready to go in, but the tape stops. Alice comes to the room. She tells them according to the book she read, there is a demon named Idimu. If you stay awake too long, the demon will get in. This is what is happening here. Patrick opposes her, and saying they only need medicine, they argue with each other, then she leaves the room. Alice has gone off to bed to read a diary she found and hear whispers coming from the vent. Patrick and Carla come to a conclusion that there's probably a tape left in the camera. They find it and see that yes, everyone dies and Robert was chasing the priest to hide the tapes. Turns out Robert is a psycho and they trusted the wrong person to come down and experiment on people with. In the meantime, Alice opens the door to the patient's room. Alice goes crazy and it seems that the devil has taken her body. She dies by swallowing an electric wire. Carla and Patrick find out that the phone was never working. Christopher dies somewhere in all this as well. They find Blake in the hallway. Carla starts reciting random verses from the book, then Dr. Robert comes and he wants to get the book from Carla. Patrick is fighting with Doctor. This causes Patrick to be stabbed. Carla pours acid on the doctor. When Carla goes to the Patrick to check on him, and at this time, Dr. Robert hits her head and she becomes unconscious. She wakes up in a room full of candles. She notices that her hands are tied. The doctor comes to Carla, and throws the book on the candle fire. Robert reveals he was the boy in the first scene who was glad that the man who tormented him was murdered by a demon. Ever since, he had become obsessed with bringing the demon Idimu to this world because he's a hero. The demon apparently lingers between the sleep and real world, and Robert wanted to bring him to this world as a thank you for saving him. It didn't come to him since he couldn't keep himself up for many days, so he took the long route and became a doctor so he could be close to people who couldn't sleep for more than 18 days and use them to bring Idimu. Carla falls asleep and has a nightmare about Blake. Blake is walking on his hands upside down, then it gets dark everywhere and suddenly wakes up. She takes the lighter out of her pocket so that she can free herself with it. Blake comes to the room. Carla frees herself and goes to the book. Carla starts reciting random verses from the diary, but Robert is years of research behind him, and recites the incantation to bring Idimu to this world because Blake is already. Blake's body postures are constantly changing. Demon gets mad at Robert and tells him nothing controls me, and Robert says I just want to set you free. The demon whispering something, and that's what makes Robert kill himself by diving onto a stake. Carla asks her brother to help her defeat the demon. She finally said the right verses to the exorcism and saved her brother. The demon leaves bleak spotty. Carla picks up the key from Dr. Robert's necklace. 3 days later in the end scene, while Bleak is dozing into a peaceful sleep, Carla is wide awake. Make sure to like and subscribe and turn on the notification bell so you can watch more videos like this.